On this beautiful day, I would like to share with you about our dear former president, Shri Pranab Mukherjee. Pranab Mukherjee was born into a Brahmin family at Marathi, a village in the Bengal Presidency of British India. He attended the Suri Vidyasagar College in Suri, then affiliated to University of Calcutta. He subsequently earned an MA degree and History and LLB, both from University of Calcutta. In 1963, he became a lecturer, assistant professor at Vidyanagar College, Kolkata, and he also worked as journalist with the Deshadek Call of Motherland before entering politics. One of the sharpest mind in the government and voracious reader, each time when someone would go to him with problems, he would tell them 3 to 4 solutions and converse them to each. It was a practice whether in his ministry, GOM or at the party. A politician with many friends across the aisle, Mukherjee was facilitated with India's highest civil honor award, Bharat Ratna, last year by the National Democratic Alliance, NDA government. In 1969, Pranab started his political journey when he was handpicked by then the Prime Minister Indira Gandhi and allowed to become a member of parliament in Rajya Sabha. Although he was new to his public life, his father, Kamalakinar Mukherjee, has been a freedom fighter associated with the Congress party. Mukherjee became a Gandhi loyalist and was often described as a man for all seasons. Whatever he has achieved, he did not in his merit. He came at a national level after being a grassroots politician. So he had certain ambitions in his life. He wanted to be a prime minister of the country, and 4 times there was a chance, but it could not fructify. His ambitions made him a thinking politician who maintained cordial relations with everyone. He was not a public leader and instead a master. Pranab Mukherjee leaves behind a rich legacy of old school politics, 3 children and countless friends across parties, and a diary, the only chronicle of his life, from Nootskrip village in Bengal. In 2019, he was awarded India's highest civil honor, the Bharat Ratna, last year for his public service over 5 decades. Mr. Mukherjee had authored several books on Indian economy and on national building. Before the Bharat Ratna, the many awards and honors conferred on him include India's highest second civilian award, Padma Vibhushan, in 2008, the best parliamentary award in 1997, the best administration in 2011. He was rated one of the best 5 finance minister of the world in 1984, according to a survey conducted by Euromoney Journal, published from New York, and was declared finance minister of for Asia in 2010 by Emerging Markets, the Journal of Record, for World Bank and IMF. In his final address as president, Mr. Mukherjee said that he had received much more from the country and that he had given India's foundation as a pluralist society, was made world's largest democracy. The soul of India results in pluralism and tolerance. There are more and more things to speak about him. But dear friends, let us remember his final statement. The soul of India results in pluralism and tolerance. We have to uphold our national integrity and always become to better a human so that we can leave things which could be immoral. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.